in jungle of equipment. Jungle of equipment.
We're in the jungle.
We're in the jungle doing the bare minimum.
Hey everybody, my name's Johnny.
How's it going, Johnny?
Very good. How are you?
Doing good.
Yeah, just got to set up this dolly, and then I think we're good on this side.
Set is looking fire, my guy. Let's get a quick look at this field. Shout out to Alan Brewski.
Drop.
What's up?
What's up, my guy?
I love that thing,
bro. Dude, this thing's like such Y2K vibes, bro. It has a 360 zoom.
Really?
360.
Is it actually old, or is it just like made to look that way?
It's 99.
Oh, that's cool.
So cool. Were you just standing on it for the stage setup?
Mm-hmm.
You said you wanted the interviews.
Maybe like the interviews in a corner.
Okay.
These businesses most likely aren't gonna be open, right?
Where did you want the stage? The
well, that's what I'm saying is I gotta wait for Nate.
Your call is forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 310801.
Yeah, we could honestly.
Day 20. Johnny still has no idea what art direction to get. T-minus 3 days. Still wondering what art direction to get.
Okay, so
It's a big board, yeah. So it's just gonna be like a blank canvas. Thin, you can cut it if you need. So whether you want it the long way or the short way, you can lean it up against the wall.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
We're gonna get four of the chairs.
1/5 of isolation. No clubs.
No clubs, man. No clubs.
And one again, black. Two blacks, two whites. Oh, wait, here.
You know how many like poopy hams have touched that? And you just touched your face with it.
Don't let that stop you. Don't touch me though.
You're just touching poo every single time you try to select something, I know.
Stop. Yeah, are you eating too?
Oh yeah. Yeah, I don't think we can dine in here. Oh yeah, yeah. You're not Martin. You're just Johnny. You're Jonathan.
Oh, dude. Sorry. What do you do? Look at this. See?
Whoa!
She got quick hands. You see that?
Stop.
Yeah. That's gonna be in the movie. Cowboy hat.
Kyle pulled this one.
Oh yeah, Kyle, yeah, dude, let's get him that, bro. That's way funnier than a cowboy hat.
Dude.
You wanna see? I can flip this around.
Yeah. I think the blonde hair really pulls it off.
Flip that baby around.
It's upside down, though. You gotta just tell your head upside down.
This is the L.
Oh, you put the leg bag on. Cool, you're filming her paint. Girl's missing a leg. You can't. Fucked up.
What are you doing?
This is
pretty difficult. Well, now you have
her. Yeah, I'm just gonna hold this up.
I'm Safari Wallaby.
Yo, I'm alone in the warehouse right now. Been here since early in the morning. Everyone's out grabbing materials. We're gonna get this set up. It's looking good.
I'm gonna go check on Will. He's sweating. Oh no, he's sweating. Are you okay? Aww. It's so hot. We need to get the car on for him. He's literally dying in there.
Open up, turn on the car.
Okay, where's the keys? Are they in there still? I'm here to save you.
Yeah, dude, I saw it.
I got James here, the man, the myth, the legend himself.
Just soaking it all in. Getting a feel for everything.
This guy has done the craziest things. You wouldn't even imagine what these eyes have seen.
I can't even imagine. And I did it. I saw with my own two eyes, dude. But it's all coalesced here. It's the important part.
How's it going, Gail?
Just living life.
Editing some photos?
Editing some pictures, yeah.
Most next level photographer. What we got going here?
A lot of shit's going on.
A lot of shit.
So we have Audrey painting outside.
Can you just... No, I can't send you. I can't send it to you like that.
Y'all bored?
I like watching.
Sam, I like eating this banana.
These look so dope. Do you have anything to say about the fire creations that have been made?
This was so fun. Like, this was amazing. I haven't fully done a splatter in a really long time, so this is amazing.
That's day one.
This is my granddaughter, Kittrix, and she's a singer and a composer and a producer.
Affected either people working in film or people working anywhere in this creative artist industry that we have?
It's affected pretty much everyone in the events industry, at least from what I can see. You know, the events industry employs hundreds of thousands, if not millions of people. And most of those people immediately were without a job. A lot of musicians that were here on visas have to go back to their country because they can't, their home country, because they can't work here anymore. And gone. All of those people, right. They're just gone, and there's not enough live stream platforms to employ all those people.
While you sleep.
an interesting time to see, you know, what people's projections are for how we're going to continue if events don't start back up again. Everyone has their own, you know, ideas. Support from one another, mentally at least. In my personal experience, I find that when you're an artist, you have a little bit more fragility. You're putting yourself out there in front of people, and you have to, there's egos to worry about, there's image to worry about, there's socials to worry about, there's so much to worry about that we end up getting caught up in our own minds, and if we're not interacting with other people, we might like lose it a little bit. There's also a way you can, you know, treat this in a positive light. Mm-hmm. You know, taking this as an opportunity to learn as much as you can and collaborate as much as you can with other artists.
What you waiting for? What you waiting for? What you waiting for? What you waiting for?
this whole thing has given me a little bit of perspective of what I want to do with my live sets in the future. So I want to integrate live vocals and live piano and eventually a drummer. And I just want to say, like, antics. I want to add antics to my live performances, something fun or different. And I think that knowing how to play an instrument is a really important part in that.
And I think that's key. I think as long as you continue to find the fun and you know what you're creating and what you want to do, I think you're going to be very successful.
That's a
well hung gate.
WHG. That's a WHG. Total WHG.
Yeah, this one here. Yeah, it's a WHG.
Yeah.
I got into this cycle where I like decided I need to release a song every week, and just having that like ideal of perfection, you know, in my head. As an artist, trying to reach that, and like, you know, it's like I'm very critical of myself, and very hard. It was way too much stress at first, so I like took a step back, and yeah, now I haven't released music in a while, but I've been
How far did you get with releasing a song every week?
About a few months. I was
okay, cool.
It. Yeah, I think like 3 or 4 months.
That's the thing about your artwork that blows my mind is it's pretty. That's what I mean is like it's, well, here's the thing, is like it's pretty and it's like detailed and I love it, but the thing is like your music is like the total opposite of that. So
yeah.
What
yeah.
is like, you know, how did that come about and why is your music, you know, so dark, you know?
Yeah, so for the first part, I think it's just comes to my like personal taste with like what I like visually in the music. To me, it kind of connects together. I guess it's because it's me and my personal tastes. But yeah, with the music, I don't know. It definitely, like, with the pressure that I was putting on myself, I just, like, felt all this pressure and, like, the screaming, like, ah!
Oh, you guys are headphone jack in here? That's crazy.
Yeah, I know.
That's why I couldn't light that phone.
That's so lit.
Yeah.
Why the fuck did it? I'm just like, it just reignited a flame of me. Being like, why the fuck?
Some spiritual shit, my friends. Out of the cave we come.
I tried converting all my audio files to MP3, like some of the ones that bounce in waves that don't work on the CDJs, but didn't work.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
And MP3 works?
Get that, bro.
Crazy.
I'm tired.
Yeah.
So
Dave Gray has been here the whole time because he's a legend and an absolute homie.
Got you.
And makes the craziest beats. Stream close up!
Oh my goodness.
Those eyes are beautiful.
We're all gonna make it.
Fuck yeah.
We're in a jungle of equipment right now. We're honing in now on a couple of dotties.
Need some manpower, please.
We're closing in on young Ryan Frenzel. It's said that a freeze can consume 10 times his body weight before leading to hunger. Now, we don't want to sneak up on him. We just want to observe him, get to know him as an artist.
Freeze.
Incredible stuff.
Bird up.
Destination.
Tell me a little bit about Open Doors and why you kind of thought that this was such a necessary time to make something like this.
I thought Open Doors, there's just so many great creative people around and so many fantastic artists, and giving artists that spotlight and that ability for different creatives to work together and create something new, I think is really important.
Interactive experience. You are test group number one. And you are all here because you agreed to be a part of this experiment. Please buckle in and get ready to enter the wormhole.
Think about like other competitor platforms and like how, you know, has Open Doors kind of separated themselves to making it, you know, more about the artist and less about, you know, either it's money or, you know, fame or whatever.
Yeah, Open Doors really cares about each individual artist and really finding those artists who need that spotlight. And we're not just trying to go for streaming numbers right away. We're really going like for the dopest art out there, mm-hmm. for some art that people can appreciate. In elevating people with that.
Thank God it's Friday. 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 Thank God it's Friday. Friday. What up?
This had started back in March. Like, how did COVID-19 kind of affect like your overall vision for the website?
It really pushed it forward and pushed it into place where it just made sense that now is the time for this site that's streaming 24/7 music video content on it. And there was that idea floating around, and with everyone sitting at home and just like in the beginning of the whole situation, especially, people were like just stir crazy and looking for anything. And so it just seemed like a good solution and a good way to spend time to finally build this idea.
thoughts. I can't get enough right now. I can't get enough right now.
Saying that this is like what MTV was, you know, like back in the 90s and early 2000s, of like not focusing so much on new content and scripted television, but like, let's just share new music videos, new things happening in the artist community. Mm-hmm. And when it comes down to like your music, you know, what is kind of your process like, and how have you kind of put that process into, you know, what makes Open Doors what it is?
Yeah, I love telling stories with my music. So every song that I make, I like to put in different atmospheres that give it like a real feel, like, oh, you might feel like you're in a jungle right now, or you're near a waterfall or in a train station. I love telling a story through sound where it paints this picture of this feeling that brings up a really genuine emotion. And that's kind of the same thing with Open Doors. We want to keep it as real as possible. We want to keep it genuine and positive and authentic to art, to people. We want to work with people who are kind and care about others and are selfless. And that's really important to the whole operation.
them to come.
Well, Markiplier.
What are you doing? Finding drugs. Where's the drugs at?
What you want, dude? What you want? We got it. We got all the lights. Got the lights for the low low.
For like a long time, teach me, and like you know, a lot of like homies in Colorado where I'm from. Like I was living in like a venue space where a lot of like techno artists would come through, and so they I was like on my laptop, like I didn't even know where to start with like, you know, electronic music, and they really like set like a cool foundation. one point I was DJing and I saw like a fire, like an acre away. And I was like, whoa, what's that? So I just like stopped DJing. Like I'm all like, just like zoned.
You're there for the community, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, and I started walking up to the fire and it's like a car on fire and two guys shoveling sand on it. And I'm just like, oh, like you're putting out the fire. Like, yeah, yeah, we gotta put out this like, fire.
You gotta
like,
take care of our own.
This car like on fire.
Just such a beautiful thing. I think that's really important, especially when it comes to music creation or you know any type of artistry, to like take care of your own.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
My favorite like collaborations is this track I did with Derek, Project Human Host. That was like, if you're talking about like yin and yang, like that was like probably like the most like yin and yang like
for sure.
Thing, because you know we both like make like all sorts of types of music, especially him. And, like you know we were just like doing this song that like we were taking all these like influences and like crazy like things we've learned that like we would never thought would be like, fit, and we just did.
A song that you're really stoked on, and it's not about like the song blowing up or about the song. It's just about hearing it and hearing like creating that idea and being like, wow, like I'm grateful to even like have been a part of this creation.
Speaks to everybody, you know what I mean? So it's just like Weston said, you don't need to know what somebody's saying in order to feel like the energy in the song. Like you could be off the late night, like listening to some bedroom R&B, just get to crying, you know what I mean? And that's okay, you know, just because that's the music speaking to you, you know what I'm saying?
It's just more about emotions type.
Yeah, it's just like, it's crazy how like different songs, different genres can like shift your emotions and like, it's like mood swings.
Yeah, we could skate all day, all night long, but we're flying now, I'm not gonna let you down. Hey,
leave my phone alone, cause I ain't coming home.
So down,
I'm supposed to. To get on my nerves when you bring up all that old news. And you don't need to pretend you know what love is. Girl, I'm done. Fuck on my way with all this nonsense. Don't wait up on my conscience.
Like lemongrass. Yeah, I just might stomp out a nigga with my leather boots. You looking fruity, I'ma call you Fruit Loops. Spy kids, bitch, I'm Professor Flute. If I let my dogs loose, you gon' lose. My niggas some troops, my niggas finesse. Your mother love to touch my head, she get wetter. She sending me letters, some of them got cheddar. Telling me I do it bigger and better.
Spent the check at the names.
Now I'm fit and I'm pretty. The bitch told you that she don't like fucking niggas, but last night I got the dice sweating.
Wake up to some head and this breakfast in bed. After she wipe off her lip, collect call on my phone. This nigga been tripping, I think this nigga on the deal.
Oh yeah. This nigga been tripping, I think this nigga on the deal. Hey.
Big ass windows on the top floor. Big bamboo with the front toe. So big ass doing in my condo.
Shawty said, you a big baller, no Lonzo.
Yeah. I ain't got a time for a bitch like I fake off a mom. Yeah.
When I was down, you wouldn't answer none of my calls. Yeah. Now I see through the facade. Yeah. I can see all their flaws. Yeah. Baby, what's wrong? Am I the cause? Yeah. Only take two for a nigga to get lost. Let me pop my shit, little baby, I'm a boss. Let me tell my shit, young nigga that came up. Nah, I ain't never gon' fall off. Can't fuck with these niggas, they false. Yeah, you know what it is when I walk in.
Whenever we feel in a session that we're just trying to create something that's already been done, it doesn't give you that spark. But when you create something new, it just like creates that flame. And that's that idea of just us working together rather than climbing on top of each other. Like Eric said, it's like that's, you know, what we live by.
Recording. Yeah.
Kelsey. Don't stop recording.
You.
All right, Kelsey.
This is as much content as I'm gonna get. Currently, we're in a white girl's house. We don't know who it is, why we're here. They just told us to come here and we just listened. Then suddenly the cops showed up and Wash got arrested and I had to get him out. I fought the cop.
Free Wash.
Free my nigga.
It's a nice ass place though. Got a little karaoke machine.
They got a TV. I ain't never had a TV in my house. Shit.
Oh, look at that. That's nice.
They got internet? Dog. Ooh. Dog. What else they got? They got a mirror. They got balloons. I ain't never had balloons in my house. And they got pillows.
And they got a little table.
I can't tell y'all when the last time I slept on a pillow.
I've never even seen one of these before.
You see these? If y'all know what these are, let me know.
All right, I know I keep saying I'm a vlog, but I'm doing a horrible job at it. But today I'm gonna do my absolute best to film content. If it doesn't happen, that means I had a great night and I got super fucked up, and I'll try again the next time. But let's give it a try again.
Take a job.
Last event was Area 51.
And then, yeah.
You know, back in April. So, you know, what was that like, and how have you kind of adjusted to being a live streamer?
Area 51 was like really, really fun for me because like I got to experiment. Like live streams taught me like, oh, I don't always have to play the same genre all the time. I wanted to mix it up and play different things and see if it was possible, see if I can do it, see how like people will react to it. So like Area 51 was like the first time I really tried something different. I did like hard techno. So it was really fun because I was pretty surprised by like the reaction everyone was giving me. So like it was really cool to try something different for once. What's next now? I wanna check now. Does she double up when she come around? I wanna fuck her and her cousin too. Like what the fuck? Who are you? I need a bad bitch. That's the threat. Let me hit that. I need a bad bitch on my six pack. Better keep back and I spaz out. Another bitch on the cat route. Be in the glove, kinda clash out. Be in the club. Go nuts. Go crazy. Go crazy. Yeah. 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 Turn it up now. Go crazy.
going crazy. You can't even see me smoking on this gas. I feel like Luigi. Maybe I'm just doing something killing like a cereal. Maybe I'm just doing everything that I gotta do. EDM beats, hell shit, I'll kill some rock too. Huh, I bet it's Iron Rock Nation. Huh, I'm done being patient.
Someone doesn't vibe with you, then you have to be okay with that. Not everyone's gonna like you, but like as long as you're staying true to who you are, that's what really matters. And that's kind of like been the challenges for me and owning up to that. And like from the way I dress, the way I talk, it's like people are starting to realize this is just him. This is not him pretending to be somebody else. So that's kind of like what it's all been
but
about.
But the challenge is also like, you know, you want to do the things that you like, but sometimes you get, you know, a little comfortable or, you know, sidetracked by popularity and like doing what's, you know, now. What's
yeah, happening. It's bound to happen, but that's why you have to have a good team. Like I have an awesome team who's kept me on my shit since day one.
And you dumb shit, I don't give a fuck. Jerk up out in public, yeah, I'm in a pit. Dumb, doing dumb shit, I ain't learned shit in school, but I'm about to get dumb rich. And you dumb shit, I don't give a fuck. Jerk up out in public, yeah, I'm in a pit. Dumb, doing dumb shit, I ain't learned shit in school, but I'm about to get dumb rich.
Da Black Cult. What is Da Black Cult? What is, how can people get involved? What is
this? Da Black Cult is a movement I started with my team. It was something that we were working on for a long time. And I recently been coming up with different ways to explain it. So like the best way I can explain it is that the Black Cult isn't a cult, it's a culture. Like we're not here for just music, but it's music, art, you know, fashion, whatever you want it to be. It's about being who you are and not being apologetic about it.
Working with some big artists right now, right?
Yeah.
Dylan Brady and also Dorian Electra.
Yeah.
How did that spawn? And you know, what are you guys working on? What's cooking?
With Dorian, I met them through social media, and they put on a live stream recently, and I got to play with them and a bunch of other dope artists. So I'm sure we'll be cooking up something soon. And, sure. And I'm just excited to be working with like dope ass artists who are really stepping out the box.
Hi.
Any words? How was the past 2 days?
It was long, but it was really fun. Like, got to basically light DJ. It's, we get to do that every day, you know, for like a private rave, pretty much. Turned into like a festival.
You killed the light DJing, big time, big time. You're killing it on the sound, all the interview
thank
sound.
You, yeah.
Killing it.
Hey, thank you for having me, man.
Yeah, thank you for helping out.
And, oh yeah, anytime, dude. Anytime, man.
Yeah, you seriously like, yeah, huge, huge, huge help. And
yeah.
Super grateful for you.
Oh, thanks, guys. Thank yeah. Oh, thanks for that. Yeah.
you can kind of cut with you closing the door.
The vapor trap?
If you want.
Are we all going to walk outside the door?
Huh?
Are we all going to box
spot? What do you think about that? Is that a clean cut?
Box spot, bro.
Is that a clean cut?
Yeah, it's clean.
The open doors means to me opportunity, something new, and the chance to be a part of something great.
And when he asked the question, what does open doors mean to you? You know, answer that in however you want to answer it. You're a natural.
I just saw I only have one line.
Dude, no. You're not. I told you, you're answering the question, what does open doors mean to you? This is a separate thing.
Ah.
This is a completely separate thing. Don't worry about this. I will.
Right?
Where are we going now?
What does open doors fucking mean to you?
Open doors means to me raw, authentic, visual, music, experience.
Should we put the shoes on then?
Huh?
Is it gonna get our feet?
Probably not.
Unless,
if you're ever
to your feet, Kyle. Yeah. I don't know if we're gonna get your feet.
Yeah,
but I got your feet.
Because he's gonna be like right here at this point, right? So Frizz, you can kind of like his movement, Cole's movement. We're opening doors for artists and creatives. It doesn't matter what scene you're from. It doesn't fucking matter what scene you're from, bitch. It's open doors, motherfucker. Confused? Then I'm gonna like walk this way. Then he's essentially gonna kind of pan back to you.
Or how about we do this? We record you thinking of the shots, and then we put it in the documentary.
Hosting is really great. I really like connecting with the artists and just making sure that this guy is gonna. Can someone get this camera? I'm out of here, bro.
We go to Ethan last. We get Ethan's opinion. Blah blah blah. I come in. I say, hey, you know, we gotta go. Camera op has now made his way to this point. At this point, camera op pans, reveals me. I walk out. You guys all follow me on camera op's instructions. Camera op follows you guys out. We cut after camera op gets out the door.
Okay, but what if we do like the second camera plan?
Oh my God.
I always just love connecting with artists and just, I think, making sure that they're heard and I get the chance to kind of have this conversation about what's going on in their brain of theirs.
Ask you. Yo, what are we doing today? With some enthusiasm, as if it was the day, like, yo, we're going to the warehouse, blah, blah, blah. Then he's going to turn, revealing the rest of the gang, and ask them one by one, like, yo, y'all excited, blah, blah, blah.
Open doors says welcome. Welcome to infinite creation, infinite collaboration, infinite possibility. It's transcendence.
We're getting it.
All right,
listen.
Okay, what's the plan?
Essentially, you're right here, right?
Yeah.
All right. Now you're going to repeat, like, yo, let's go, guys. Then everyone's going to kind of, like, walk past you out.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're going to follow them out. And you're going to cut after you get out of the door. Got it.
Huge event today, dude. How you feeling?
Feeling really good. Feeling excited. There's been a lot of hard work from everyone that's led up to this point, and I think we're in a good position to make some great things happen today.
Johnny, are we going or what?
We need to talk, right?
Is that a question?
Yeah, what's the lines?
I'm supposed to get a question.
I told it to you guys like three times.
What is it about today you think is so special, so like exciting? What is that feeling like?
It's definitely bringing all these different creatives together. There's so many great people involved on this project. I can genuinely say every single person's a really nice individual and everyone contributes something to this project, and so it's gonna be amazing seeing everyone working together, and I'm really excited for it.
What are we doing today, Frizz?
Today's the warehouse. Very excited for today. It's gonna be a good one.
Let's do it.
Kyle, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Yeah, it sounds great.
Are you guys playing Smash? Let's go! We gotta go to the warehouse!
Right,
we gotta go to the warehouse, dude!
Our hearts go out to everyone affected by climate change. It's something we all need to address, and we should do it not just soon, but right now.
Bitch. Made Kirby my little bitch.
Arizona, 14 years ago, and there's a man there, Chester Copperpot. We fell in love, and he died. But before he died, he told me something very important. Open doors, he said. If you do anything in this life, open doors, my good boy.
Got it.